Generic greetings! In the previous episode, I managed to make and indeed misspell the rubber dinghy rapids, which was slightly embarrassing, but either way, as you can see, it is quite a large piece of kit. In fact, in terms of square footage, it's probably about as big as the park. Like, this is what we've made, and then this is obviously the bit that we've been messing around with, and obviously there's a lot more detail gone into all of this, but still, it's, yeah, it's a big piece of kit. It's actually quite long as well. It probably takes about a full day for someone to go around the entire thing, which, when you consider it is only 20 generic units of currency to actually ride on this, it is good value for money, and also making a lot of money. As you can see, we've got 14,000 in the kitty. So, in this episode, what I'll be doing is going through and pretty much altering the land a bit more, adding things like rocks and features and other triggering effects, things like that, because it's a little bit bare bones at the moment. So, let us do that. Obviously, I've gone around and changed the colour of things, so you can see now the rubber dinghies are actually green, and the actual trough that it goes in, for the lack of a better term, is like a blue colour with like a sort of standard steely type look for the support. And I've went and changed a couple of the land pieces just to try things. So this, for example, has been raised up so you go inside. Obviously it needs a lot of work, that's what we'll be doing in a moment. Stuck this out as well because it was essentially just a big square, which is, yeah, it's a little bit more. It's a little bit more than that now, so it looks a little bit more, I wouldn't say natural, but it looks a bit better. So, yeah, I want to put a little thing in there as well. So, not bad at all. Right, let's crack on. We've got a train. I'm going to go to pull, and we want to pull this up and have it so that as you come along, you, like, enter this cave. And actually, that's pretty much all I wanted to do there. That's fine. I'm just going to alter it so the terrain doesn't look as formed. Now, what I'm going to have to do as well, I have to make sure that when you come along here, you can still see up and over the park. The whole point is when you come along, you can sort of see the entire park there, which is, I think, what we've already got there. That's fine. We're going to go to push and just push some of this down. Now, a lot of this, we have to be very careful because you can see it's very, very close to the edge of the map, which means we have some problems when it comes to clipping and such, so I have to be careful about that one. So we'll just sort of push this about. We'll need to pull that back because, as you can see, it's opening the area up, which is something we don't want. We need to sort of make it thicker and stick out like that. And about there is fine. Yeah, that's fine. Then we'll just push this back in just to make sure it's about level, which it is. There we go. Right. Oh, no, that's terrible. That's terrible. I'll pull that back out a bit. See, there's something underneath there that's not doing it properly. Ah, it's not. It's clipping a bit because of the, like, the height of it. What I'm going to do is go down and just widen this up by using push. We'll go to, first person mode for the camera and allows us to go through it, and obviously it widens it up a bit as well as makes it less chiseled. Okay, there we are. We've got a couple of things to look at. We've got things broken down of all, as always. They'll be fixed. They'll be fine. Everything will be fine. Go to park management, and we've got Back to the 80s, which we can unlock the research, which is a coaster. The Equalizer will also reveal a Sky Ace, apparently Thrill Ride, and finally a Radius Family Ride. Excellent. We'll start research on a coaster and also a Thrill Ride because we're getting close to the end of research. I mean, we're spending a lot of money on research. In terms of money, we don't really need it at all, to be honest with you. Anyway, back over to terrain, and we'll go to probably pull, and we'll increase the size of that, and what we're going to do is just raise the land up about here. As you come along, we want to be able to... I don't know, maybe you do want to see over, but we do want a bit so it's like a little bit hidden and stuff. Finally, our ride's been fixed, that's good. What else do we need to alter? Well, perhaps it would be nice if I... Actually, what the hell's going on there? There's a bird pecking at the way. Oh, there's loads of birds pecking away at this thing. Okay. Anyway, I think that's about right. That tunnel's fine. This coming down is not too bad, but I do want to push it so it's not right up against it, as you can see, because it makes it a little bit iffy. Just looks not right. We do need, because this does slope right down like that, we could, if we wanted to, have this underground, but I'm not too sure. What's probably going to be best if I just got to pull and increase the land around this area, just so, again, it doesn't look too, it looks too shaped at the moment. Like, it does look definitely like that is the edge of the mountain because it was a square. So if I just, like, pull it around here, you can see we'll get a nice gentle slope off, and also it, like, sort of, it makes the struts go further up, so it looks okay. And that's not too bad. push it back down again on this corner. There we go. And then make sure we do the same thing. And this is quite nice. You go through like a little valley here, which is okay. And then you go up and out, and then you get a nice view of whatever's going to be over there. Maybe it's not going to be anything. Maybe we're not going to get there. If current view numbers are like they are, well, probably not. Right, we'll push this down, and there we are. That's fine. Yeah, that's okay. Just sort of roughing this up manually. In fact, I don't even know why I'm roughing it up manually. I'm just going to push this mountain back a bit as well. We can go to rough and increase the size of that and just do a little bit of a roughing there. There we are. There's been a couple of comments. Most people saying that they quite like it. Some saying we should actually repaint it, so like go to the terrain and painting and change it to like all rock. I am not against that. I mean, the problem with doing it all rock is that it doesn't look as good, I don't think, when you do it all rock. Like if you did it like that. No, I don't like that, so we're just going to undo. Actually, we don't even need to undo. We'll just go to painting and repaint. Actually, no, we won't repaint it. We'll just undo, because if you repaint it, it automatically sort of textures parts. There we go, we'll just undo them. That's fine. Oh, hang on. And redo whatever I've just undone. There we are, fine. So, what else haven't we done? I think we were going to probably do a... I think it's this texture. Hang on, I'll just head over here quickly. And we did have a... Yeah, that's the texture I wanted. We do have a texture over here for the underwater part. And obviously we do want to sort of copy the same sort of... idea, because it's like a quarry type thing. It's been mined out. Now obviously you won't see it because the water's there. In fact, what I'll do is I'll remove the water first and then I'll paint it. So there we are. And then paint all of this one. Maybe this bit is a good rocky outcrop. That might be quite nice. But we'll see what the rest is like. And we need to go around. I'm only doing the underground bit. And then the rest I will do with water in, because then I know where the edge of the water is, so I don't have to like do more work than is completely necessary. Remember, work smart, not hard. So, there we go. Yeah, that's not too bad, although if we had that as grass on the top, like so, and then on the side we had it as rock. That might be quite nice. Oh yeah, that's okay. And it blends quite well. There we are. Right, sorted. Okay, there's that. So what I want to do is, I want to obviously build something around this, but I probably want to have it so it juts out and then comes down. So, click on that. We'll go to start building on station grid. We'll go to custom, and we need to change our filters to probably the scenery set of planet coaster. And actually, no, because that's just going to give us all the signs and such, isn't it? No, we don't want that. Reduce that down. Go to building material. And do I really want that? Or building set modern. Building set modern is probably the way to go. And yes, it gives us these walls and stuff, which is what we want. So I want to have it quite... the other one was quite close, the previous coaster. So what I'll do is I think I'll have like a... like a windowy bit all the way along, like that. We can't go to there, sadly. That'll probably do, though. And then we'll have, like, a entrance there. Rotate it round. That's fine. Same thing for this side. For there and then there. Yep, that's about right. That's fine. Now, obviously, on this side, we do need just straight chunks. Actually, we can't put it there, but we can put it there, which is what I want. And then there, and then we'll go over to this side again, and one there, and then one there. You can see it's going into the mountain, because that's the idea. And we'll build it into the entire mountain, you see. And then, And then, Where do we go from here? Do we want to go to the bottom like that? Or do we want the struts to be shown? I don't mind the look of the struts, so maybe we will. I'm not sure. I'm going to have that in, so it's like a very open section. Like so. And then we need... Well, I'm hoping there's a beam. Is there a beam? That's the question. Should have really asked that before I went ahead and put that in. Actually, let's undo those a second. And do these fit in better? They probably do. Actually, we could almost certainly put in a wall there. Yeah, we can put a wall in there. That's fine. We'll get rid of those. And panel wall won't go in there. But that will. Okay. That's fine. And then over to panel wall. Nope. That one. Yes. There you go. Excellent. That's what we wanted. Done. Right, so it's a fairly big building, as you can see. But I think it's best if we go probably underground like so. And I can't go in because of where it is. That. See, I like the struts there. But I don't know whether we should stick with it or not. Obviously, we'll have to put these panels in. Maybe we should have it from the sides. Like, maybe from the side, we'll cover it up. Should we just realise that that's in the wrong place? Move that. There we are. Maybe from the sides, we'll have it covered up. Perhaps. Or perhaps not. Let's try it. Yeah, that's okay. We'll undo that section. What I want to do is just rise up to there. Put it down to there. It's okay. It's not great either. Perhaps. I'm not sure. Let's put these in first. We'll continue going because it's fitting in. And the whole point is we can make a it's not about making a bad decision, it's about making a decision. And then, you know, if we change it, then we change it. That's fine. We can happily change our minds once we're done. But there's no point in umming and ahhing about it. And going, oh, shall I do that? Oh, shall I put that in? Oh, shall I? No, just do it. Just make a decision. Do it. See what happens. And that's not too bad. Okay. So what I want to do now, I want to put a roof on the thing. And the previous roof, we went with these sort of slopes. As you can see, we've got them ones. So we'll go with that slope. And we'll change it so the whole front of it is not apparently on the roof. Hang on. There we go. And we want to just go along. But I want to have a gap in the roof. Like a deliberate gap. So it comes along. And then a hole in the roof somehow. I don't know if there's any hole in the roof sections. I know there's like flat panels like this. But I don't know if there's any others. A gap would be quite nice. Perhaps what would be good is if we went... Oh, I know what we'll do. And that'll probably theme with how I was going to do it in the first place. The whole point is to have this so it like goes up to the wall. Excuse me. Got a bad throat for some reason at the moment. So that'll come along. And then we'll go to a flat roof section like so. I'll rotate it round. So there, 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 and then inside. Okay. Same on this side as well. Up to there and then in. But then we'll go a long one. Like so. And then we'll slope up again. And have... is that how I wanted it? No, that's the wrong panel. Undo those. Slope up that way. That's the one. That's the one. And then get a one of... Hang on, where is it? One of those, maybe? Have to get them in the right place this time. I mean, that's the wrong section, but something like that. No, I'm not a big fan of it. Take a step back for a moment, have a think. Today's beverage is just a cup of tea. So, what sort of panels could we use? The whole idea was to let more light in. But what's the best way of doing that? I'm not sure. While I think, I will finish these panels off. Obviously, there were several comments saying we should change this to like wood and stuff, but that's been... I'm already on the verge of like pretty much copying what people have done with rubber dinghies anyway, so I didn't want to make the sort of wooden styly ones with the like the mine shaft and the what would you call it, like a sort of wooden struts and barricades, and I wouldn't say western-y style, but it's that sort of that look, that feel. So I wanted to avoid that. And I've just realised that there might not be a section for this. There is a section for this. That is fine then. That is most good. We need to put it like that. There we are. And do you like say I wanted to get more of an openness to it. But I don't know what the solution would be. Oh, actually, I might know what the solution could be, actually. Yeah, actually... Words, noises. Noises of thinking. Plus 10 generic thinking noises. How about, let's be a maverick. One of those. Along the side to the end. That could work. Okay, let's... We're gonna have to do the roof first, so we'll finish the roof off. Because the whole point with the roof is that it was going to then curve back over anyway. So it would do that, you see. So we've got a nice curvy roof. Spin it round here. And we'll try and find where it should go. It's not going in at all. There we go. And then it just randomly rotates round and positions itself nowhere. Now it's fixing. There we go. So curves to that. So obviously we have to put in a curve back that away. Back that away. Like there. And rotate it. And then in. God. There. Okay. And one in there. Come along here. Wrong. This is obviously the first pass of the building. If we decide that it's terrible in every single way, we will delete it. And then this one, we're not going to delete it. There's no way. We'll edit it, but we're not deleting this thing. It's taking far too long. That's a problem. Look at that. If we just were, if the whole thing was just a little bit further, it would be okay. If we get three on either side, that's fine. And this one, we'll have to go even further. What I'll probably do, because I can, is simply go to sculpting and push. And push that terrain back in there like that, as you can see. So it opens it up. And then this side will pull and pull it in like that. There you go. Sorted. Right. And we will... How are we going to do this? I should finish off the building. Click on that. Edit building. Over to the... Oh, damn it. Right, why it doesn't save the filters? I don't know. Building set, modern. And it is the flat panel. Otherwise known as the extremely shiny surface of doom. And snapping, which just doesn't work, apparently. Oh, no, no, it just reset everything. Oh, why? Look at that, it goes there happily, but then you have to manually alter it. Alter it? Alter it. We could do another curve up, but I think that would be... That would just be going too far and showing off, wouldn't it, really? And we are going to have to put in a little bit more roof section there. But for the... Just for the sake of completeness, pull 1 metre. Actually, no, what? Not 1 metre, because it makes it too... too problematic. Because it tries to, like, do loads of stuff. Right! There you go, there's the building. You know what? I'm happy with that. I like those little windows. Now, what on earth we can put in here is really up to you. Like, I don't know. Obviously, we need some lights in here. And we need something at the back. We can't just have this. Well, we can just have this if we really wanted to, this section here. But what I'd prefer to do, ideally, would be to have, like, a bit of a wall. And then something else that's inside here to look really cool. But I'm not going to do the inside of the building now. I want to know what you think, and then we will go back and do it. Okay, so there's that. Let's crack on with the other stuff. Remember, this is a first pass for the entire thing. This is going to take quite a while to do. I just need to check on park management. Go over to... Oh, we research. We haven't actually sorted that out. Oh, we haven't finished it, rather. Okay. That's fine. So, we'll go to... Where do I want to go? Actually, one thing I want to check. I want to check the overall guest thought. And guest thought is quite happy. Park is great. Not queuing for that long to go on the Rub Dinghy Rapids. Not queuing for that long. That's fine. Queue looks fast there, but not queuing that long. Hang on. What? They don't want to queue very long, but then they also say the queue is good. So, that's dodgy. In terms of park rating, it's been going up and down. There you go. Ticket prices, that's... We don't even touch it. We don't have ticket prices. Look at them. Stats are all over the place. They're up and down all over the place. Let's just check. Last 2 years, pretty flat. Last 5 years. Oh, God, it's all over the place. That's like YouTube statistics now. Just all over the place. Actually trending down for the most part. Not mad. Staff, we don't really need any more. I know a couple of people have said we should get, like, some of these other ones, like Cosmic Cow and stuff. I don't see why not, why we can't do. We haven't got a Chief Beef. So let's get a Chief Beef in here. And how about a Cosmic Cow? We got a Gulpy Rex. Well, we got a Gulpy, so we'll get a Gulpy Rex in. And then finally, we'll get a Cosmic Cow. There we are. Sorted. Right, so this is moving along quite nicely. What I need to do now is go to, probably back to this. We'll go to Edit Building, and we want a door. There's a door that opens and closes, I believe, and it is apparently not in there. Maybe it's in Scenery, Door, try it, Door. And yes, there is a coaster door, as you can see, and it just goes wherever you place it. Cool, right, so we're going to have that, close that. I'm going to go over to Scenery, Door, and we'll have a coaster door in. Could easily put it in here if we wanted to. Do you want to put them in here? What would that look like? See if it actually opens and closes properly. Okay, that actually hits. We'll probably have to put some triggers in. Okay, it just keeps opening and closing. Activate on trigger, it says. Okay. So it does activate on a trigger. I don't mind that, you know. It's not bad. I think we'll have to toggle advanced movement and then put it so it goes... It's at the end of, like, these splashy bits. There you go, that's fine. And then, actually, you know what we'll do? I thought, pull this back, pull it up, and then we will go to... Probably... see, that's a piece of scenery. The question is, can we make it a building by adding to it? Don't think so. That's the problem. It's because it's a piece of scenery. And what I'd have to do... to extend it... Yeah, it's not got a grid. I'd have to make a building for it to sit on. One, two... Hmm. OK, Okay, let's try and make a building. 1, 2, 3, like that. And then we will have a section that is a little bit thinner. If I can find like a thinner section. Maybe those on either side and then up like that. I think that's how tall the doors are. Let's move this over. Let's click done. We'll move the doors. So they're bigger than that. Right, okay. But they go there, you see. Right, okay. But at least we know the size of it now. And then we'll edit this building once more. Edit building. That will move. Can we put it... No, because it's snapping to the grid. I mean, we can change the grid size. Move that to there. Right, move that to there. No. Maybe change the grid size again. If we move that, could we center the door? Oh, damn it. Change the grid size back. If we move it, could we then center this door somehow? So that... No, it's always going to clip through, which is a shame. It's a crying shame. However, there might be something we can do. Is there like a half wall section? Is there a half wall? Thinking noises again. If there's a half wall section that's vertical. Nice, that's custom panel squares. There's only that. And there's that. And you can't Z rotate it that way 90 degrees, not the other way. Question is, can I click on that and go to... No, I can't. I can't change it the other way. What would the solution be? That's really small bits. That's not even snapping to the grid. That's just weird. Okay. We will have to go with... None of it works. None of it actually works. The whole point was to have it so it would... have it all, like, connect up. See, look, there's a big gap there. It's not working. It's not working. I'm done with that building. But it did place that section in. I was going to have doors on there, but I don't think it's going to work out. Oh, well. I was going to have doors. It's not worked out. C'est la vie. Right. Over to probably some scenery and we'll do some rockage. Start placing some rocks in places. We'll go to align the surface and, again, go around and shove some rocks in places. And obviously this is, again, all first pass stuff. This will all be changed as and when. We do need to probably go around and alter things at least a couple of times before we get it even somewhere near to what we think is correct. But I'm very concerned, I'm very conscious rather, about not spending like loads of time on this thing. I don't really want to spend, you know, 6-7 episodes or whatever on this. Unless you think that's a good idea, and by all means, let me know. But the whole point is we want to get it looking nice without really overdoing it too much. Because there is a level of, like, acceptance. It's like, look, that looks fine. It's not, like, great, and we could definitely improve it. But we could just declare victory and move on. And... keep just smashing some of these rocks in. There we are. What the hell was that noise? Oh, something's been broken and they've just fixed it. Good, good. We'll have to go put some bushes in here as well. It's a bit iffy that all these rocks are on the top here. You would think, oh, are you going to clear them? Well, we plan to, but what if they roll down? Ah, well, that's why we've got a big roof on here, you see. What you mean, so it bounces off here and then lands on all the crowd there? Yeah, pretty much. Oh, well, at least you've thought about it then. Oh, yeah, definitely. We did a risk assessment, decided that we didn't care. Which is terrible. Right, so we're getting there now. Perhaps a couple of big more rocks. More big rocks? Big more rocks? More big rocks. Same thing around here, we'll have to place some rocks. That's quite nice. A couple of smaller ones, little boulders and that. Just put one on the top. No, it looks terrible. Most of them look terrible. Don't know what it is about it, just doesn't seem to fit. There. Okay. So, first pass with rocks. Dull a couple of these little small ones around. Little small. Yeah. Double descriptors. Nice. I know Englishes. I know all the words and stuff. It's a fast, passable first go. Let's just check the queue scenery rating on this one. We're on... Clicky. No, 10%. So, crap, essentially. Okay. Do I want to finish off the building and put the... cover the struts? I think I do. Edit building. I've decided that that is the way we're going to go with it. So, we'll have to make sure we get this right. Although, to be fair, it's not that difficult. Although, getting them here, like a tiny little piece, if it was like a tiny bit lower, it would be okay, but it's not, so... Yeah, we have to do that. Right, and we've got the same issues we had last time, is that it looks very, very flat at this front. So, what sort of thing can we put here? I reckon the way to go is water. Get some water put in. Push, and push right down, like that. And because, obviously, this building is... quite low. Look at that, because we put them bits in, it shouldn't look too bad. He hopes. We could even go underneath this queue. That might be nice. And, oh, hang on. We've gone a bit too far there. Now we'll keep pushing. We'll just raise the land up a bit more. So push this down. Put him go around here. Oh, that's a deep hole. I've just dug a massive hole there. Obviously, it's going to be very sharp on this corner, and we'll alter that in a moment. Down here. Down here, you see. Because of how far the building goes, because we planned ahead. Sorry, I couldn't keep a straight face actually trying to sell that to you. We didn't plan ahead at all. It's just lucky that we got that far. Look. Oh dear, oh dear. Right, we'll pull it back out, you see, just so it's definitely covering the building. And, yeah, push again. Push it down here to this queue section. And that's about right. Okay. But what we'll have to do, we'll have to do something along this, because as you can see, it's just, it's terrible. Like, it's not smooth at all. It's very, very sharp. So what I'm going to do is... Oh, good. Not that, apparently. Maybe smoothing. Maybe smoothing will help. Nope, it just puts a big chamfer on the whole thing. We're going to have to make an artificial corner for that. We'll have a railing and like an overhang. Maybe even part of that. Let's just put the water in first. See what it looks like. It just looks like it's leaking, to be honest with you. It's not too bad, though. And I like that. I like that the building is pretty much stuck between a mountain and a big pile of water all the way around it. That's quite good. In fact, there's nothing stopping us, as far as I'm aware, in connecting this up. There you go. Didn't really think about it that way, but yeah, no, that works for me. Yeah, excellent. Oh, nice. It's more water than I originally envisaged, but I can deal with it. I can handle that. I'll be fine. I'll get over it. And push this down. Obviously, there's a lot of water under there that we need to probably push this down as well. There you go. That's okay. Queue's a bit iffy. We'll have to sort that queue bit out, but other than that, not too bad. And it has automatically coloured it, but just for the sake of completeness, we'll make sure that it's all been done around here. And do you want to make that like a big rock section? No, that's terrible. It's just terrible in every single way. And along this corner here, obviously there's underground bit which you need to deal with as well. Probably have to remove the water. You know what, there's a certain point where you can't see it, so we don't really need to, if I'm honest. And all this is going to be covered anyway. Like, what we're going to do is go around and make like a some sort of railing that goes around. Now obviously we've got, we might as well push that down while we're here. No point in one little section. There you are. So we do need a railing around. We've already got a railing here. But we'll... No, we can't put a piece... We can't put that on there. That's interesting. See that? It just won't do it. That is very strange. Very strange indeed, actually. I don't know why that won't go on. It says uneven terrain. I mean, it is... Okay, it's quite uneven, I must confess. Perhaps delete some of this section then. And then we'll go over to terrain. We could have a natural path. Never actually used one of those. Width, 10 metres. And you sort of go along like that. Why is angle snap on? You have like a natural path like that. You know what? That's not too bad. It's different at least. I don't know if that's a good thing. There you go. It still doesn't fix the problem of I didn't sort the land out. Hang on. Terrain. Flatten the surface. Increase the size of it. Not too much. 6 meters. There we go. It should be better now. So we'll get rid of the path. We could even probably, if I'm honest with you, just maybe even think about using this old pathway. Apparently not. Train too uneven. Because of that. Strangely, the bit I've just caused. There we go. Reduce the length a bit. Yeah, it still won't go in. But the natural path. Oh, that's wrong. That's back in. Yeah. We'll have to remove a section in a moment, but natural path. Oh, that doesn't even fit in now. Great. Fantastic. Yeah, now there we go. Said it would fit in, but it doesn't apparently. Okay, it's just lying to me. The whole thing's lying to me. Let's get rid of this section. Hang on. Path. Curb on ground, yes. Path spots, yes. Railing on ground path, no. So, it connects up to there. Then it goes this way. And then it goes along. And then apparently it just doesn't fit. Terrain too uneven, apparently. Well, pretty sure that's as flat as you're gonna get. There's not much flatter than that in terms of the terrain. Yeah, this is just weird. Path's just totally broken. Right, that's a future me problem. I'm going to go around and alter that path. But let's think about the railing-y bits that's going to go over there. So we're going to have to go to building. And we'll make a new building. And it will be probably something like that. How do we want to do it? Building set, modern. And then we need to have essentially a big bit that goes down. And then maybe what we need to do is have an overhang that goes down into the water and then comes along flat. I don't really know what sort of sets we would have. Well, that might be quite nice if we do that. Oh, hang on. Get rid of that for a second. So we'll have this piece. Put it there for now. Right. Like that. Then we could even have, if we wanted to, a bit of roof section. I think this is going to look too much. I think this won't look as good. But we'll see. Put that there. We're going to have to move those. Why is it snapping like that? Yeah, it doesn't snap when I'm doing that. Snapping is iffy sometimes. Right. Roof section first. There you go. And then this, which doesn't snap properly. Cool. So that doesn't snap anymore properly. I don't know what's going on there. Everything is breaking today. Either way, we need some sort of overhang here. And I was thinking, I'll just place it in. It would be something like that, and then go straight down. Don't know if that would... No, see, that wouldn't work entirely how I wanted it to work. We would use the same railing. We've got something similar here, look. So we would just say, duplicate. And we do that. You know, we would have a railing right across it, like so. All the way along. But we need it sort of... Sort of not like that at all. But we do need, a ledge that goes over it. Anyway, you know what? I think I'm going to leave it there because I'm having a lot of troubles with this path and I don't want to spend the next 25 minutes trying to fix a path. And that would just be a bit annoying. And I need to sort out the edge pieces. And there's a lot of lit around here. I need to put, obviously, some bins and stuff. So anyway, not a bad bit of building. We've altered the land. We've added more water, which now I think looks really good, especially when you consider the path's going to go around here. We'll have the edges when we fit it in. Obviously, this building quite good. What I really need to know is, where do you think we should go in this building? What direction? Should we just put a big wall up here so you can't really see it? What do you think we should do there? Obviously, we need to do things like lighting in the caves, as well as little rock drops and water and things like that. But either way, let me know in the comments, and we will go from there. I think it's starting to look okay. This path is not something I'm happy with. I thought it would be okay, it might be a bit different, but it just doesn't look very good, to be honest with you. It just doesn't fit what we're going for. It's very strange that we could get only so far with this path. I'm going to try it once more. Yeah, it gets to there and just doesn't want to go any further. It's like, nope, 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 nope. It is just a flatness surface problem, I think. Increase the size of it on the right. Is that it? Is it just that? No, I don't know what it is. I don't know what it is at all. Okay, so I fixed the problem. It was just that. The good old, oh no, we're not going to do that. And then it sort of fixes it. Strange. Strange. It just... size. Push that back, you see. Just because we want that all the way back to the wall. It's getting a little bit sharp. You can see, like, the edges of it. But, you know. Not too worried, because you can't see under the water. There we go. Right, so we will leave it there. Next episode, we will go around and we want to place some railings along here. Some proper ones that we make ourselves. But in terms of how successful the park is, I think it's very successful. In terms of money, it is, well in profit. We've got a couple of things to reveal on research. There you go. There is a Black Falcon coaster. We've also got a 360 power thrill ride, and we can now research another coaster. Another coaster, and finally, another coaster. So you've got alternate launch, freedom of flight, and enormous speed. So, yeah, not bad. Making money in terms of guest happiness, we can see they are quite good. Saying that's disgusting, we've got a lot of litter and stuff, which is a problem, so we need to sort that out. This is very successful in terms of the money it's making. Let's have a quick look. Obviously, we do need to sort that queue out, which we really should have done before now. Rating's not too bad, but it's like it's a bit of everything. You know, it's family rides. You know, there's loads of families going on it. People seem to like it. That's fine. That's okay. And in terms of money, yeah, it's making loads of money. 24,000. What's this made in total? 133. So actually, this is quite good as well. But either way, there we go. Not bad. Next episode, go ahead, do some railings, do some more detailing, and just crack on. As always, hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks very much for watching. Take care, and generic partings.